Noble Middle School, you know what time it is. We are proud to present, once again, the epic, legendary, unbeatable event that no other middle school provides. Noble Field Day has returned, and it will occur on June 7th, 2023. We're going to talk about rules. We got to talk about points. We got to talk about flags and trophies. So let's get to it. Here are the rules of Field Day. Number one, first and foremost, we're going to have fun. Absolutely. Number two, please make sure you're wearing shoes. Number three, stay within your boundary. Each homeroom will have a designated area in an end zone. Number four, there is no arguing with any judge, any adult, any teacher, period. Number five, play fair, follow all the rules. And then last but not least, make sure you clean up after yourselves. Let's talk about the points you can earn at Field Day. If your team takes first place in any event, you get 10 points. Second place will get you 7 points. Third place gets you 5 points. And everybody else gets 3 points. If your teachers participate in an event, they earn 3 bonus points. They can do that 2 times for a maximum of 6 points. And trust me when I tell you, every point matters. Your team flag is so important at Field Day. Your homeroom teacher has received a blank template, and it's up to you to design and create your team flag. We need all of these turned in by Friday, June 2nd, so they can be laminated, posted, and be ready for you and your team on Field Day. This is your symbol. This is your banner. This is what you are bringing to the field to show everybody else you mean business. So make it a good one. So one of the best parts of Field Day is our trophies. One of the toughest things is getting them back from last year's winners. Our teachers, they love the trophies. Come on, let's see if we can get one from Ms. Whitaker. Let me put this down.
I was willing to come off one.
Wait, you think this is a negotiation? Is it over here in the blanket? This is why Noble Field Day is epic, legendary, unbeatable across all levels.
You came to me. Not a problem. There's the spirit award. Someone made some modifications.
It's amazing.
That's a good looking
guy. Now, I will just say, as president of All Things Field Day, this has not been endorsed or condoned.
That's how it was given to me.
This is how it was presented to me.
That's how it was presented to me.
As you can see with our historical footage, these are the original trophies, and I'm excited to announce that our 6th grade Spirit Award will actually have a new design in 2023. Pool Noodle Polo is back. It was a successful game last year, so we were excited to bring it back for this year's Field Day. The concept is real simple. 4 players, you're going to ride a horse, you're going to use a pool noodle to hit a dodgeball across the field, go around the cone, bring it back to the stables, switch them out, and keep it going. First 4 players to be finished will say yee-haw. Here we have a brand new game that we've brought to Noble Field Day. This is Cheeseball Chuck. There's a lot of prep work that goes into this. You're going to need safety goggles, a shower cap, your teachers are going to get to put shaving cream on your head, and then your four teammates will each have their own bag of 10 cheese balls. The object of the game is simple. Your team is trying to get as many cheese balls to stick on your head as possible. They will take turns throwing two cheese balls at a time and then rotating to the back of the line. When they've gone through all of their cheese balls or time has expired, we will stop and count to see who has the most cheese balls on their head. Be careful, mind your balance, because you cannot replace any of the fallen cheese balls. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, ten. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, seven. 10-7, winner. It's time for the 4x1 relay race. And as you look at the diagram for this year's race, pay attention to the fact that we have switched the orientation of the race. We now start 1-2 as a short run. 2-3 will be a long run. 3-4 is short, and 4 to the finish line will be a long sideline run. So teachers, as you assign starting numbers, use that information to your advantage. And students, as you are running this race, make sure you focus on clean handoffs and make sure you save enough energy in the gas tank to finish that long sideline run. Remember, you are racing against the clock. Top times will get top points.
What are you doing?
Hmm?
What are you doing?
Nothing. Me? Just hanging around.
I'm just hanging around. That's what I do. I hang around and I think about field day 24/7. And then I think about favorites. I think about how people develop preferences. They have certain tastes for different things. And field day is no different. People have favorite games for field day. Descrambled has quickly become the favorite game. And as I walk around and ponder and think about this, the question is why? What makes Descrambled so great? It's like a great pancake recipe. There has to be a key ingredient that makes it great, that brings it all together. And as you look at the main objective of Descrambled, it's so simple. The object is to move a group of letters from one location to another and then descramble those letters to create a secret phrase. Now, each grade level has its own secret phrase. And I gotta tell you, I think this year, the secret phrases might be the most challenging yet. But I believe in my heart of hearts that as you provide transportation for the letters from one spot to another, you will find success. You will succeed. You will be victorious. As we get into Descrambled each and every year at Field Day, people are hungry and thirsty for clues. They ask me all the time, is this a clue? Is that a clue? But truthfully, those that are able to make observations will be key to your Descrambled success. And, you know, you may start your clue searching career here in one location, and then you find yourself completely somewhere else, and things are just screaming at you, and you find yourself eventually coming back to start. And as we switch over to the video demonstration, you see we have six individuals. Four are holding a rope, and the other two are working to either deliver a letter to the line or retrieve a letter from the line. Now, the four individuals holding the rope, they've got to work together, they've got to be in sequence, and they've got to make sure they only have one letter on the line at a time. If a judge sees more than one letter on your line, you will serve a 3-second penalty. penalty. So please make sure that your team is all in step, all doing the right things together. Because this isn't some fancy farm picnic out in Kentucky or somewhere like that. This is Noble Middle School, dog. This is field day. This is the scramble. There's a lot of pride on the line. So make sure your team is working together, looking for these clues. Don't get tripped up on the fake ones. Always look for the real ones. And as we slow down here and close the show, my final piece of advice is just to make sure that you and your team don't leave any rocks unturned, don't leave any trees unclimbed, don't leave any bridges uncrossed and no lids unlifted as you make your way through this descrambled process and ultimately towards your final destination of an amazing field day. So I tip my hat to you, I wish you the best of luck, and I'll see you soon. This game is Service with a Smile. This is a brand new creation for Noble Field Day, and we are excited to see how this challenge plays out. Now, your team will have four players, and one at a time, you will go across the field with an empty cup, place it on a tray, and return it to your team with a smile, hopefully. The next person will take that tray with one cup, go and fill up a second cup, and attempt to return both cups to the line, but make sure that make sure that you place the cup on the tray and then begin moving. The rules are very simple. You can only use one hand to carry the tray. You can only move when you have cups on the tray. Now, when you are behind a cone, like you see here, you are safe to move, rearrange the cups in any way. When you are behind the cone, your teammates can help you move the tray, transfer the tray, but as soon as you move beyond the cone, it has to be one hand under the tray, and all the cups have to be on the tray. Now, if something happens and you spill water, if you spill your cups, you have to start over. You have to go back and you have to refill each cup one at a time. So make sure that you are mindful of your balance, you're staying focused. And as you go through, like right here, he's behind the cone. He's okay. He can rearrange it. He can change position any which way he wants. Like right there, he's getting it all back under control. That's legal. This is a timed event. You have 4 minutes to get all of this done. Now, if you are quick and you get 8 cups on your tray, you can pour them all out into your empty bucket and start all over again. Because again, the winner is going to have the most water. So best of luck to you. We can't wait to see all those smiles at field day. The Sponge Bucket Relay is a classic, and Noble Middle School has used several variations throughout its years of field day. And in 2023, we bring back the classic relay race where you run, you soak the sponge, and then you place it over your head to the next teammate. And when it gets to the back of the line, they have to squeeze as much water as they can into the bucket, and you keep the process going. This is a timed event, so be quick and efficient. The team that collects the most water will get the most points. Jump the Creek is one of the oldest games in field day history. The concept is so simple, yet so difficult to master. You will send two players, one boy and one girl, from your homeroom to represent your team. Their job, their mission, is to jump across the creek. Each round, the creek will grow in distance. It will widen with each successful round. If at any point you touch either rope, whether front or back, or you land in the middle of the creek, you will be eliminated from the game. The Barefoot Bucket Balance Challenge has been one of the most exciting and also frightening events in field day. And as you can see here, the concept is four people laying on their back with their feet in the air are trying to balance a bucket of water. And then they have to remove their shoes one at a time without spilling any water. It is very difficult. It requires a lot of teamwork, a lot of communication, and a lot of trust. And as you move your way around, removing your shoes, the strategy is up to you. You just have to remember, you have to have shoes such as tennis shoes. If you wear Crocs, they must be in sport mode. And as you work your way to the end, maybe you'll be like this group and successfully complete the challenge. It's time to talk about Limbo, a classic game at any party, but also a classic game for Noble Field Day. Now, Noble Middle School, we are the only school in New Hanover County that provides a field day for its students. As you can see here, we have a custom-made Limbo apparatus. Now, the two players that you send to this game, any combination works. They have to move forward, they have to bend backwards, they have to prove their flexibility, and there are some things you cannot do. Like the lunge. You also cannot do the side pivot. And we don't want you to duck under the bar either. And if any part of you or your body touches the ground, you will be eliminated. But this right here is a successful example of good limbo form. Rock Tree Bridge is a 10-person game where 9 people are working to build a human obstacle course. You have to go in pattern. You have to go Rock Tree Bridge. As you advance through the course, you have to jump over rocks, you have to run around trees, and you have to climb under bridges. Now, it's important to remember, you cannot start moving until the person in front of you has completed their run. You cannot start moving until the person in front of you is set. Once they are set, you can then begin making your way through the course. The last person, lucky number 10, will run through the entire course. They will jump over the rocks, run around the trees, go under the bridges. They'll do that 3 times. And then when they get to the end, they will run around the cone. Once they go around the cone, they have to do it all again on their way back. As you see here, these two teams are very close together, but one team has a lead. There it is, going around the cone, making their way back. Once you successfully go through each obstacle and make your way back to the starting cone, make sure you raise your team flag. If it's raining on field day, we will simply move inside. We have rainy day alternates ready to go. Jump the Creek would be replaced by this game, the Hula Hoop Transfer Game. 6 players will be connected, and their goal is to move the hula hoop through their line. Once the hula hoop passes you, disconnect from the group, run to the front, and reconnect. The winning team will have the hula hoop successfully land and drop on their end cone. Make sure you're not cheating, otherwise you'll have a 3-second penalty. The next rainy day alternate game will be the torch relay, and it will replace the barefoot bucket balance game. Now, this is a game for four players who will use tennis rackets to hold a dodgeball above their head, similar to a torchbearer making a run in a race. Make sure that you are only holding the taped handles as you run. First team to get all four players around their cone and back to the start and sitting down will be victorious. Peas in a Pod is a classic Noble Field Day game, and it makes for a perfect rainy day alternate for the Sponge Bucket Relay. We have six players who will be working together in pairs, running across the court, using pool noodles to pick up and transport dodgeballs. With each trip, you are adding one dodgeball. So the first trip, you carry one. The second trip, you will be carrying two. And the third and final trip, you have to carry all three dodgeballs back to your starting location. Keep your hands on the tape. Only let the noodles touch the dodgeballs. And make sure you have all three under control behind your starting cone to be victorious. Here we have the basket flip. This will replace service with a smile, and it is a tried and true Noble Field Day classic. The concept is simple. Put the ball in the basket, flip it, and have both the basket and the ball land upright without losing any of the materials. If you miss, leave the ball in the basket and run back to your line. Make sure that you are running and tagging your teammate. Please do not run before the tag. There will be a 3-second penalty for those that are cheating. Once you have successfully flipped all five baskets, raise your flag. And now it's time to unveil the sixth grade tug of war championship bracket. We turn our attention to the first contest. A former Spirit Award winner, Mrs. Whitaker, will be taking on a former Spirit Award winner, a former overall champion, Mrs. Adam, who is looking for the final piece to her trifecta dream in Field Day glory. The next contest, we will have Mrs. Miller taking on the GOAT, Coach Shaw himself. And as we move across the bracket, we welcome in a newcomer to Noble, Mr. Scarletto, as he has the tough task of taking on the reigning and defending tug of war champion, Mr. Hicks. The final contest in round one, we will see Coach Elder taking on somebody who has a great last name, Mrs. Nobles. And we say best of luck to all of our tug of war participants, and we will see you on field day. Here is the seventh grade tug of war championship bracket. There are a lot of epic matchups in round one, so we're not gonna waste any more time. At the top of the list, the reigning defending overall back-to-back champion of field day, Mr. Rogers, will be taking on Mr. Garrett, who is looking for his first field day trophy. Moving down the list, we have a former Spirit Award winner, a former Tug of War champion, Miss Perdome, just on the cusp of a trifecta club membership, will be taking on a newcomer to Noble, but not that new, Miss Lane. As we move across the bracket, we have a mathematical matchup between Mrs. Keegan and Miss Mendoza. That's going to be a knockdown, drag-out one for sure. And then finally, in round one, the last matchup, the latest inductee to the Trifecta Club, Mrs. Rogers will be taking on the reigning and defending tug-of-war champion, Mrs. Kellum. Best of luck to everybody involved. And here is the 8th grade tug-of-war championship bracket. There's a lot on the line for the students as this is their last tug-of-war tournament, so let's make it a great one. We start with our opening contest. Ms. Zay, one victory away from a Trifecta Club membership, it has to be this tug-of-war trophy. Standing in her way, the mathematical wizard herself, Mrs. Yarborough. As we move down the bracket, two field day rookies will do battle in round one. Mrs. Udi will be taking on Mr. Locke. Now, as we scoot across the bracket, we have a former two-time overall champion, Miss Kevitz. She will be welcoming in another newcomer, Mrs. Moore. And finally, our last matchup of round one, a Trifecta Club member, Miss Mazelia, will be doing battle with another rookie, but he's got some dog in him, so don't sleep on him. He'll look to lead the pack off of the porch, talking about Mr. Neal and his homeroom. It's going to be a great one. We're almost there. We'll see you on June 7th.